Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I'm Varsha Sitaraman and today I'm going to be telling you what to do right after your CA exams. So hold on, let's get started. Step one, relax. Please relax. A lot of people would have a lot of questions right now as to what they should be doing next or why they're suddenly so free. You don't know what to do with your time because all these years, all these months, all these days, all you did was study day and night, and the little relaxation that you got was TV shows that you were sneaking in here and there, or movies, or anything that you love for that matter, like going out for a walk, going for a run, and that too, everything was timed because you had to get back to a schedule, you had to get back to a routine. Now all of that stops. So take a break, relax. It's completely okay to just do nothing. Doing nothing feels like a crime in a day when everyone is hustling so hard or everyone is doing something so productive. So you might feel like you're doing a crime by just relaxing, but it is absolutely not. Now is the time to relax. And when I say relax, go back to all those hobbies which you do not have the time for. It could be learning a new language, it could be singing, dancing, and whatnot. Spend more time on social media if that's what you do, or maybe where you can also productively spend time on social media by following the right set of people. But do absolutely anything that makes you happy. Don't follow back into a schedule or routine now. You can be free, do what you like to do best. Spend more time with your family and friends. Your social life would have taken a beating, to be very honest, because we are in this field and we know what we've been through. So spend more time with your friends, catch up with them, like let them know you're still alive and well and you're still kicking, because a lot of them would have thought he or she has gone into CA and we're never going to talk to them again. So go and reconnect with those friends. Have fun, chill, watch as many movies, watch as many TV shows, spend more time with your family, because now's the time to relax. You have 2 golden months before your results or whatnot might come through. But for folks who are very confident about their exams, just relax, everything is going to be fine. Now step two. If you are uncertain about how your exams went, and when I say uncertain, all of us are uncertain. Sometimes even the people who get ranks or first rank is uncertain whether he or she passed or failed in a particular subject. But if that uncertainty is to a limit where you kind of know you might not make it through, then take a couple of weeks off after your exams and get back into studying slowly for the next group. If you've given only one group this time, or if you're thinking you've given both groups and you might not make it through both of them, take a couple of weeks off, or take even a month off. It's completely fine. Take a month off and then get back into the studying mode. But make sure you do take that break, because a lot of people would just get back into that grind or that hustle or that routine right after, and you might not be very productive because your brain is fried. Bheja fry. This is it. That's how what you'd be feeling right now. So make sure you take as much time as possible to relax and just do absolutely anything other than studying to break that monotony. And for folks who want to be as productive as possible, even in this relaxation period, but productive in their own way, this point is for you. You can do some courses like financial modeling courses, or courses involving around Excel shortcuts, or being very good at Excel, like your VBA or SQL queries and whatnot. Or you could take a holistic MS Office course in itself. There are multiple programs available online on Unacademy or Udemy or Coursera and whatnot. There are multiple platforms, or even free on YouTube, where they teach you how to use a Word document, how to make presentations, how to be very good at Excel, like the shortcuts that I mentioned. Microsoft Office is an ecosystem in itself, and every organization would use this for varied activities. So regardless of the role that you apply for, these would come in handy, so you can always go for courses here and add value to your technical skill sets. 2, soft skills. Soft skills are very, very important and are often missed out in a curriculum like CA, despite your programs like GMCS and whatnot. So now would be the right time to imbibe these soft skills. We can join Toastmasters Club, or you can join a small group of friends where you, it doesn't have to be some formal educational program. You can just get together, have a set of friends where you test each other on your soft skills in a way that you end up becoming better as a, you end up articulating better, you end up speaking better, you build your confidence in terms of public speaking and whatnot. I also have a video on my channel, I think one of the first videos I posted, on how to speak or improve your communication skills. You can watch that video too and instill some of the techniques I've mentioned there, and that would be of great help. But to what I mentioned, you can gather a small group of friends and help each other out, and pointing out as to what mistakes they did, what mistakes that they have pointed out for you, so that you can work on them and build your soft skills. because these will often come in handy during your interview process, like your group discussion or just one-on-one interview. All of these become extremely important. So now's the time that you would want to work on all these if you want to be productive as possible. Another thing I can think of and would be extremely helpful right now is to read finance news. A lot of us would have been extremely detached from this whole social media game or from your phone itself, and rightfully so, because you were focusing on your exams. You did not want a lot of distractions, especially during times like these when everywhere it's flooded with negative news. But now's the time where you get back into the game, update yourself with all the recent affairs, know what's happening out there. Again, you can form a small group on WhatsApp where each of you share important finance links so that you learn from each other, and you can also have discussions where indirectly you are preparing for a group discussion by exchanging opinions, exchanging thoughts, understanding what the other person has to say and rightfully replying back to that. And also, this would build your knowledge base in general, because often interviews these days are more practical oriented and not just textbook where you're like, they just ask you direct questions, but as to how what you've learned in your practical papers or even your theoretical subjects, how are they applied in real life in the consequences, or they might take something that's happening right now in the M&A space, the startup space, and now where we are in an IPO frenzy, they could ask one of questions which could connect to that and ask what you think about it. So in those cases, it's very important that you know what is happening in the market out there and how you connect it, and just preparing for it 2 days before the interview would not help your cause, because that's something that you create as a habit over a period of time. So now's the time to do it. Preparing for group discussions, preparing for interviews, it's not a one day thing. Again, I have videos on this separately on my channel, so it would be great if you can go and watch those too. But generally speaking, it's good to build your skill sets on these fronts too, where you build a knowledge base. And it would be great if you do it with a bunch of friends, because helping each other out always motivates each other too. And having a healthy discussion or a healthy argument or debate always adds value to yourself. There's no such thing as a wrong choice right now, because you're in your early stages of your career and it's great to experiment in the next 3-4 years, but it's always good to also assess and know what you want for yourself. It could be next you want to study further, you want to do ACCA, you want to do CFA, you want to do a CPA, or absolutely anything that would add value to your profile. You want to go for an MBA, so you prepare for a GMAT or a CAT and whatnot. Any of these would require introspection of what you want to do, and that happens now. So as long as all these points that I've mentioned, you relax, you spend time with your family, you also do your hobbies, you also stay productive. Some might even go back to their articleship. But all of these happen in simultaneously, so it's also the time to introspect, like I mentioned. So take this time off, have fun. So now's the time you do all of this. Just spend a lot of time with your family, spend a lot of time with your friends, connect, reconnect with others, reconnect with yourself, have a sense of peace and calm wash all over you, because you have been hustling hard, you've been tirelessly working 12, 14 hours, studying and putting in those notes, writing. Give your arms a break, give your mind a break. But at the same time, if you still want to be productive, like I said, all those things I mentioned in point number 3, you can do that. But on the whole, stay relaxed, stay safe, stay calm. I'll see you in my next video with more topics for CAs or any career for that matter. Stay safe, take care. Until then, bye-bye.